Hello, my fellow handsome journal. I'm Piotr Glotnik from its improvement the channel dedicated to make you look, feel, smell, and be like the best possible version of yourself. This video is about skincare, specifically about the only Nivea skincare product you should ever consider buying, in my opinion, of course. Nivea is a brand that has been around on the market for a very, very long time, and I'm not a very huge fan of the brand because they tend to use a lot of fragrance in their products. I have previously made a review of their AM and PM Q10 Power Moisturizers, and if you're interested in that, the link will be here in the corner. So instead of reviewing a lot of products in a lot of videos, I'm just going to show you every single Nivea product that I would ever consider buying myself and recommend to you guys. Let's start off with face washes, and I only got one, and the one I got is the Nivea Sensitive Cleansing Milk. The reason I recommend this one is because this is the only face wash I could find from the brand that I could get my hands on that was fragrance free. There might be other face washes from the brand that are fragrance free, but this one was the only one that I could get my hands on and find. On the bottle it says that it cleanses deeply and helps to reduce redness, tightness, and dryness, and that it contains dextrose and grape seed oil. Ingredients wise, there's glycerin, panthenol, grape seed oil, as it says on the bottle, and cetyl alcohol, just to name a few of the ingredients. It has a lot of good ingredients that will keep your face moisturized, so if you suffer from very dry and harsh skin, this might be one to check out if you're on a budget. This face wash isn't anything special, but it's definitely one of the better products that I have tried from the brand, because it does what it says it needs to do on the bottle, and it costs around $5 to $6 for a 200ml bottle, so you can't really complain. In terms of rating, this gets a 6.3 out of 10. The only downfalls I have with this product right here is that it's very thick, but since it's called a cleansing milk, there's your reason. The other and last downfall I have with this product is that it contains an unnecessary ingredient called sodium stearate. Sodium stearate is an ingredient that was used very, very long time ago in soap bars, and the ingredient is known for being very harsh to the skin. But as long as it's not used in soap, it isn't harmful. But it's just an unnecessary ingredient to put in here, in my opinion. So if it's in any way, shape, or form harmful for the skin, why would you put it in here? But again, if it's not harmful in this and only harmful in soap bars, I don't really care, but again, it's very unnecessary, hence the lower rating. In terms of moisturizers, I got two. The first one and my favorite one is the Nivea Men Sensitive Face Cream. I've mentioned this face cream in a few videos prior because this is one of my favorite moisturizers to use, and because of the price and the ingredients, and since this being fragrance free, is very decent for what you're paying. This also feels very great on my skin and works and moisturizes my face for a fairly good amount of hours. So there's a reason why this is one of my favorite moisturizers, because it's very cheap and does the job for me. This one gets a solid 8 out of 10 and easily my favorite Nivea product. Second one I mentioned shortly in my Q10 Power Moisturizers review, and that is the fragrance-free version of the Q10 AM Moisturizer. In the prior review, I thought that the fragrance-free version would be a lot better and a lot less harsh on the skin. And I was right. This feels way better on the skin, and since it's fragrance free, this is a win for Nivea. The only downfall I have with this is that it's a little bit expensive, even though it's not very good. I mean, it's decent, but it's not very good. And since you're paying $23 for this, it doesn't really match price with the product. So that's the only downfall, but again, this is a massive improvement from the original, since this is fragrance free and feels a lot better on the skin. Rating wise, this gets a 6.4 out of 10. Lastly, I got eye cream, and here I only got one as well, and that is the Nivea Q10 Power Eye Cream. This one is fragrance free and essential oil free. This has Q10, glycerin, dimethicone, capric triglyceride, and vegetable oil, to name a few decent ingredients. It's the only fragrance-free eye cream that I could find from the brand and get my hands on, so hence this being the only eye cream that I recommend you guys to ever try from the brand. A few problems I have with this one is that it's very, very thick. It takes a little while before it gets absorbed by the skin, and sometimes you can accidentally rub it in into your eyes a little bit too harshly, hence it's not working so well. It's a decent eye cream for the price, which is around 18 bucks, I think. But this one isn't a necessary product, but if you were to go for a Nivea eye cream, then this would be my only option and recommendation. I will give this a 4.8 out of 10 because this isn't anything special, and since it's so hard for the skin to absorb, but again, it's a decent product. As an honorable mention, I have any of their deodorants and roll-ons. They aren't anything special, but they're convenient and do what they need to do. They help you to sweat a little less. They most likely have aluminum in them, which isn't very good. But again, for the price of 1 to 3 bucks, it's very convenient. And if you can get better deodorants out there without aluminum, go ahead. But again, this is so cheap that you can't hate on it. It's convenient and cheap. I didn't include any serums, body creams, or hair products because they all include ingredients that aren't needed in the products. For example, serums, all of the serums that I could find from Nivea are filled with fragrance, and that just isn't necessary, and they are also expensive, so I would never buy an expensive serum that is filled with fragrance. If I'm going to buy an expensive product, I don't want any bad ingredients in it. In terms of body creams, there is the infamous Blue Nivea cream. You can buy it, I just won't advise it because it's filled with fragrance. You are going to smell of Nivea the whole day if you apply it on your skin. And hair products, there are a lot of better brands out there for your hair. So definitely have a look at other brands, and therefore I don't recommend any of their products at that category as well. These four products that I mentioned, including the deodorant, are in my opinion the only Nivea products that I would ever consider recommending to you guys, because they are the best products that I have found from the brand and that I would personally use and reuse again. I would advise you to explore the internet and find some other brands that might be a lot better than Nivea for the reasons that you need them for. There's a lot of better brands for your body and skin and hair than Nivea. It's of course a very cheap alternative, so if you're on a budget, you can definitely use these products that I mentioned here. But if you have a bigger budget and you want something better for your body, skin, and hair, then of course I would 100% recommend you guys checking out other brands that are out there on the market. I hope this video helped you find the best possible products from Nivea and the best possible products you could buy from the brand on a budget, and help you form your own opinion on the brand and the product that I mentioned. If you enjoyed the video, gentlemen, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already for more content like this: fragrance, skincare, hair care, style, fashion, fitness, dating, self-improvement, anything that will help you become the best possible version of yourself. And of course, press the notification bell so you get notified every single time I upload a new video for you guys to enjoy and learn from. Until the next video, smile more, it's free.